You're watching the free version of Mocha Essentials. Follow along with projects and footage with a premium download available at borisfx.com.
Hi, I'm Mary Poppin with BorisFX, and I showed you a really basic example in the previous lesson. Now we're going to talk about PowerMesh tracking tips. Sometimes your PowerMesh just does not want to track properly. This section is going to cover some basic troubleshooting techniques you can use to get your results back on track. So making sure your smoothness is correct, thoughtful use of tracking mats, and adjusting your shape prior to tracking. So first things first, let's evaluate our shot. All right, I want to create a nice tracking mesh on our friend James's t-shirt. James is moving around quite a bit. The lighting is changing quite a bit. And we have to worry about his hand moving over his chest with a shadow. So just like any Mocha shot, the first thing that we need to do is create a garbage mat. I'm going to create one big garbage mat around his arm, track translation, scale, and rotation, and hit track backwards. I'm going to speed up this workflow so that you don't have to sit through me rotoscoping a garbage mat. But I really want to make sure that I track outside of the occlusion to grab all of the motion blur that would move over the shirt. And that's good enough. We're going to trim our layer. And I have a nice garbage mat for his hand. I'm also going to create a garbage mat for his shadow over here. We'll link hand shadow to the hand track and do some quick roto correction to make sure that we have as much texture as possible to track. All right, that's looking good. We're going to turn the gears off for those, lock them, and hide them. Now, just like any planar track that we do in Mocha, we want to make sure that we create our shape thoughtfully. If I want to put a logo on his shirt somewhere around here, I need this shape to actually be much bigger than that because I want to account for the tug of this fabric. So let's widen this shape. And we're going to create our mesh bigger than the area that we track. So let's track perspective. And let's use mesh warp. Let's call this t-shirt track and move it underneath our occlusion layers. Now, I don't want to use automatic contrast. We want to use uniform. And we're going to use another 32 for our average distance between mesh vertices in pixels. Generate mesh. And now I'm going to take my shape and make it a little bit smaller. But I still want all of these vertices around my shape to give me a nice border when I apply my data. Let's hit track backwards. And let's see how our PowerMesh does. Looks like it's doing really nicely. So let's jump to our keyframe that we created and hit track forwards. Because we've moved our track underneath our hand and hand shadow holdout layers, Mocha will not use that data, meaning the occlusions won't damage my PowerMesh track. If you run out of good area to track, you can always increase your search area and continue tracking. Those last troublesome frames at the end are because we don't have our rotoscope glued to the inside edge of this shirt. So let's actually animate this shape inside of our shirt again. So now let's retract those frames. And I want you to notice that when we retrack, we won't be leaving points on the background again. As I said before, the PowerMesh is extremely sensitive, so you want to make sure that you tell it to only grab the good data that you need. The rest of the points will be driven by the planar track when PowerMesh cannot find the subplanar data due to occlusions. Unlike optical flow solutions, PowerMesh allows you to watch how the tracker is tracking in real time and then allows you to correct problems as you see them. Since each frame only takes a couple of seconds to process, you can really see where the problems are. You're not leaving the process overnight and then coming back to discover that you have serious problems. When all else fails, you can also hand animate your points. In this instance, I've got a little bit of sliding on my power mesh. So I'd like to select Edit Mesh and select some of my problem points. I'd like to go to the last good section of data that I have and make a keyframe. Making sure to select my Edit Mesh tool, I can now move these mesh points over. Since the rest of these points don't really matter to me, I'm going to leave them alone. They're outside of the area that I need to worry about. That's much better. All right, so we've covered setting up helper layers, creating the right shape for the task, dealing with turns, and manually adjusting the mesh. Next up, Power Mesh for rotoscoping.
You've been watching the free version of Mocha Essentials. To download all videos, projects, and footage, purchase the premium version available at borisfx.com.